Just blaze, make it not. Ladies, if you're walking through the mall and you hear somebody say, easy, you gotta turn back at them. And you know what? I gotta do the same thing.
Come on. Tell them what's up.
That's that new 2003 car, ladies.
For show.
For shizzle.
It's so, so dead.
Cable line was struck by lightning. As Calvin was getting the shoes from the cable line, the shoes got affected also by the lightning, and Calvin fell from the tree. As the shoes was affected by the lightning, and the temperature from the lightning is very hot, then the shoes would be burnt already because of the specific heat of lightning, as the material of the shoes cannot handle it. But in the movie, the shoes was not physically affected. To correct the violation or misconception of the scene, the shoes that was really affected by the lightning that hit the cable line should be damaged or burnt because of the temperature of the lightning, as the shoes can't handle the temperature. That is why it should be affected physically by the lightning.
Calvin, a 13-year-old orphan, plays one-on-one with a NBA player and suddenly dunks from the free throw line, leaving the crowd in shock.
Happy feet! Wombo combo! Hands up! Oh! Oh!
In the move, you can see that he didn't have much of a run-up, but still was able to get to the rim in less than a second. Michael Jordan has already done this, but I don't think a 13-year-old 4-foot could. This misconception could be correct if Calvin did a layup from much closer, and a run-up that would create enough energy for him to leap that far. This would look more believable because we don't usually see people that are 4-foot dunking. At 13 years old, you can only jump a few meters and not 15 feet. Thank you very much.
When Calvin gets to the stadium using a scooter and sees Bitter Man in the way to stop him, Calvin then pushes or releases his scooter, then it hits Bitter Man, then he flies to the wall.
Your game is over.
My game's just beginning.
Mr. Bitterman is most likely to be a heavier object than the scooter, but when he got hit, he flew like a rag doll. Bitterman shouldn't fall so far because the scooter is most likely not heavier than him. To correct this, he must fall near or less farther because every action has an equal opposite reaction.
When Calvin touches Michael Jordan's old shoes right after he got struck by lightning, his hands didn't get affected. He was able to touch a fully intact shoe after it got struck by lightning with no problem. This is a misconception because the specific heat capacity of human flesh is not enough to withstand the heat of lightning. To correct the misconception, Calvin should have had a third degree burn after touching the shoes because of its high temperature characteristic. Or, if he touched the shoes with heat-protectant gloves. These gloves have a unique material that protects him from burning himself.
It's Monday morning, I gotta get up and go to school. I wish I could
Calvin was very impatient, as he just left the cart on the street. He did not put it on brake, and he stopped on an inclined street or upscale land, and left the cart. Then the cart rolled down the street. When Calvin parked the cart in an upscale land, as soon as he parked it and left the cart rolled down the hill because of gravity. Physics concepts was applied in this scene because the cart was not put on brake. That's why it rolled down the hill, because of gravity. Friction is also a factor here. That is why it rolled down too. And in the end of making a noise. Friction helps here as it would never stop if there is no friction. A vehicle will really roll down if it was placed on brake. And on this scene, the cart was parked on an upscale land, resulting this scene to have applied physics concepts.
Calvin, a 13-year-old orphan, was signed to a NBA team. He then set up a play where he would pass the ball to his teammate. Projectile motion could be seen here because enough force is applied by Calvin to reach a person 2 to 3 feet away.
Calvin slides the book on the shuffleboard and gets to the end.
In the meantime, you have your geometry work with you?
Yeah. You know a little something about geometry?
Do I know about geometry? It's a lot of copycatting, but I know who you're with.
Can you holler at this big dollar getting sitting pretty hard and representing so Calvin applies a good amount of force of the book. And since shuffleboards have smooth and slippery surfaces, there is less friction, thus making it be able to reach the end.
When Calvin was called to the court during the halftime show, he used the mic to talk to everyone in the audience.
What's your name?
Calvin Cambridge.
Well, Calvin, I'd like you to meet Tracy Reynolds.
I'm playing Tracy, I'm playing Tracy. I can't even say it, I'm so happy I'm playing 2 times. Wait a minute, was I supposed to do that? Man, this is kind of loud. Hey, stand up, can you hear me? Murph, stand up.
Calvin!
I can't hear you. I still can't hear it. Jump up and down like a rabbit or something.
Crab is eating this up. Don't embarrass the kid. Let him score twice.
Once.
Rich, twice.
Once.
Hey, Murph, we gotta get one of these. I gotta
Okay, Calvin. Very good. Now you're gonna have 60 seconds, okay? Let's get the show on the road!
The microphone creates a voltage that is similar to the sound of your voice / voice inputted. Then the sound is inputted to the speaker, which amplifies it to a larger group of people for them to hear it properly.
Bye, have a beautiful time.